Hi everyone, my name is Ashish Gupta and in this video I'll be discussing the second problem from Google Kickstart Round Day 2020, that is plates. What the problem states is that there are n stacks of plates, each stack contains k plates and each plate has a positive beauty value associated with it. We would like to take exactly p plates to use for dinner. And it is also given that if we want to take a plate from the stack, we must also take all of the plates above it in that stack as well. So for example, if a stack contains 5 plates and if I want to take the 4th plate, then I must also take the 1st, 2nd and 3rd plates from that stack. So we want to take p plates such that the total sum of beauty values is maximized. For the constraints of the problem, we see that there are up to 100 test cases, k is up to 30. And the number of plates that we have to take lies between 1 and n into k, which is the maximum total number of plates. The beauty values themselves are between 1 and 100 inclusive. There are two test sets. For test set 1, n is up to 30 and for test set 2, n is up to 50. So let us see the sample test cases. In the first sample test case, we have two stacks of plate, each containing 4 plates. And we want to take 5 plates in total. The first stack has 10, 10, 130 as the beauty values and the second stack has 80, 50, 10 and 50 as the beauty values. Since P is 5, we must take at least one plate from each of the stack. So the possibilities are that I take one plate from the first stack and 4 from the last one, or 2 plus 3, similarly 3 plus 2, or all 4 from the first stack and 1 from the last stack. So among all these possibilities, we get the maximum value of 250 when we take 3 plates from the first stack to get 120 and 2 plates from the second stack to get 130. So the total beauty value becomes 250. Similarly, in the second test case, we have 3 stacks of plates. The second, each stack contains 2 plates and we have to take exactly 3 plates. The values are 80, 80, 15, 50 and 20, 10. To get the maximum value of 180, we must take both the plates from the first stack and the first plate from the third stack. So we get 160 plus 20 to get 180. It is not possible to do better in these test cases. So how do we approach this problem? First, we notice that test set 1 has n only up to 3. So we can have a brute force recursive or iterative solution. Here iterative solution would be worse because while we can have 3 nested loops or 2 nested loops depending on the test case, it is not generalizable. The time complexity of a brute force approach would be k raised to n, because for each stack we have k plus 1 approaches, like k plus 1 options for each stack. I can take 0, 1, 2, till up till k number of plates from a particular stack. And if I brute force over all these possibilities, I will end up with k plus 1 raised to n total possibilities. So the complexity would be k raised to n, whether I do it iteratively or I do it recursively. But if I do it iteratively, I will need to have as many number of loops. So let us, like for example, in the second sample case, if I want to brute over taking 0, 1, 2 from the first stack, 0, 1, 2 from the second stack and 0, 1, 2 from the third stack, I would need a for loop for this, a for loop for the second stack and a for loop for the third stack. And the implementation can get really messy because it is dependent on n. However, if we use a recursive approach, then the approach is generalizable for any n, even though the time complexity stays the same and the space complexity increases because of the recursion stack. But so let me discuss the recursive approach through code. First, I will define the recursion function. Let us think about what states we require for this recursion to work. Suppose I'm traveling from the first stack to the last stack. Then when I'm on a particular stack, ith stack, first of all, I need to know which stack I'm on. So that is one of the necessary parameters of the recursion function, that is the idx, which stack I am on. Assuming I am on the ith stack, I also need to know how many plates I have taken from the first I minus 1 stacks. So together these two parameters, that is int idx and int taken, basically how many plates I have taken so far, seem to define the particular state that we have all the information we require when we are on this stack. Now let us think about all the possible transitions. Since on this stack, I have k plus 1 possibilities. I can either take 0 plates, I can take 1 plate, and I can take up to k plates. So I have a for loop for all the possible transitions. I denote how many plates I choose to take from this stack, and this taking I plates would give me a value of prefix of idx I. That is, I can have a prefix array for every stack. So for this stack, the prefix array would be 10, 20, 120, 150. So basically that means that if I want to take the third plate, then that means that I'll be getting a value of 120. So if I'll get a value of prefix of idx I, and I will move on to the next stack and increment my taken by I, because I have taken I further plates from this stack. The base condition should be that if taken is equal to P, then we return 0, because we cannot get any further duty value because we have chosen exactly k plates that we wanted to. Similarly, another base case could be that we have exhausted all the stacks but we have not taken the P plates that were required, or that we have taken more than P plates. Both of these cases are invalid because we wanted to take exactly P plates to use for dinner. So since it is an invalid state, I never want my recursion to reach this state, and if it does reach this state, I do not want the answer to be affected. So since the question asks us to find the maximum total sum of beauty values, what I can do is I can return a huge negative value over here, such that even if the state is reached, it won't be considered, because inside this for loop, I will have something like answer is equal to max of answer comma this. So basically, even if an invalid state is reached, then this whole value becomes negative and that state is essentially not considered, and then we can return the answer. So if you want to analyze the time complexity of this approach, we should just realize that for every stack, we are exploring all the k plus 1 options that we have. So the complexity turns out to be k plus 1 raised to n, which is sufficient for clearing the first test set. That is, since n is only 3, we have k up to 30. 30 raised to 3 would easily fit in the time limit. But what we can realize is that this recursion, how many distinct values can these parameters take? So let's see, idx goes from 1 to n. Similarly, taken goes from 0 to p, because if we take more than p plates, then I return minus 29, and similarly, if idx becomes greater than n, I return minus 29, and both the variables are only ever incremented. None of them are decreased at any point of time, so they cannot become negative, since we will start with recursion of 1, 0. So this means that there are n into p distinct states. There are n into p distinct states, and inside each state, I'm running a loop of size k. So essentially, the time complexity of this approach, if I'm able to store these values somehow, should be O of n into p into k, whereas the space complexity would only be O of n into p. And storing all these states is nothing but dynamic programming, because I do not want to recompute the values again and again. If I have calculated recursion of 5,4 before, then I can simply use its value when I encounter it again, instead of again running this loop and again exploring all the recursive calls. So to memoize these states, I can have a cache array. N is up to 50 and k p is up to 50 into 30. So I have cache of n into p. To store, how I store my dp is I initialize all the values with -1, so I can basically memset my whole array with -1. So if this state has been visited, if cache of idx taken is not -1, then that means that I have visited this state before. So I can simply return cache of idx taken. However, if it has not been visited, then we can do the same thing. Like basically, whatever we have done so far is remains the same. But when returning the answer, we can store the value in cache of IDX taken, so that if this state is visited again, then we do not come to this part of the recursive call. We only stay limited to this part, and this reduces the time complexity from exponential to n into p into k. And this is somewhat of a knapsack DP if you're familiar with, if you've done problems with knapsacks, then you will see that there is a similarity, because at each stage we have an option of either choosing a particular number of plates from this stack or we do not. So let me try to complete the code. We have n, k and p as the input. We also need to store the values, beauty values, and we need a prefix array for all the stacks. So let me first take the test cases. The variable tc will store the test case number I am currently on, because it is required in the output as case number 1, case number 2. In the input I take n, k, p for every stack. I take the input in array A as aij, ith stack, jth plate, and I also maintain the prefix sum, that is prefix of ij would be prefix of ij minus 1 plus a of ij. So prefix of ij is basically stores the ith, if I'm on the ith stack and I take j plates, then what is the total beauty value I get. Then I move on to the DP part. I memset my cache array to minus 1. I then call the recursion function with, I'm on the first stack and I have taken no plates so far, and then I can output the required answer. Let me just cross check my code once. Int recursion of int idx comma taken, if taken is p I return 0, if idx becomes greater than n or taken becomes greater than p, then we should return minus infinity because this state is not valid. If the state has been visited, I return the value stored in that state, otherwise I calculate the value for this state by iterating through all the possibilities, that is taking I plates where I goes from 0 to k from this particular stack of plates. I take the maximum of all the possible transitions because we want the maximum answer. And yes, it seems correct to me. Let me try to run the code. Yes, it's working. I'll just submit it and cross check it once. Also, I would like to tell you something about memoization. In this question, we only have two states, so we need to write cache of IDX taken everywhere. However, there may be questions where there are multiple parameters, like 5 parameters or 6 parameters in the recursion. So look at this older submission of mine. What I do is I store it in a variable, a shorter named variable. So for example, I stored the value of cache of IDX taken in a shorter variable answer, and using this ampersand, I'm basically making it a reference variable. So any value that I change in answer is also going to be changed in cache of IDX taken. So as you can see, the code is almost same, but over here I only change answer. I'd never have to define or use this long variable again, and it can help save time if you're rushing through the contest. Thank you.